Offer.
It's fine.
You win.
Why are you so? Did you grow even more? Hey guys, welcome back to another KP and Alan video here.
Yeah.
Would you say you're an AJR hater?
Yes, I don't like their music. No.
Personally, would say I'm a big fan of AJR. Right?
Yeah.
Here's the video: AJR hater versus
You're gonna make me react to
fan.
Something?
Yes, I am. Fan,
oh
super fan. I'm gonna make you react to, well, we're just gonna do the first six songs of it because we don't want to make the video too long, but I'm gonna make you react to the first six songs of the newest AJR album. And
they're still making
this
music?
Yes.
Who buys that?
For me, except I don't buy it, I just get it free on Spotify. And watch or react to the first six songs.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously probably not gonna like it. That's okay. We're not looking to make you an AJR fan today. I just want to get a reaction from you, kind of seeing how different our reactions to the song is, and hopefully we can kind of come to some sort of agreement. So,
I understand. Is this even on?
No, these don't work.
So why are
they're for show.
Oh, that's cool, I guess.
Yeah.
Well,
the KP and Alan studio. What's that, Alan?
It's, is it the AJR album?
It's the AJR album. Go to the computer, shall we?
Oh boy. So that's why you didn't want me to see your room.
We tried to do this once. Kind of, the power went out on us here. Anyway, so, again, reacting to the Maybe Man album. Alan, I think I've showed you one song out of all of the album. Like, way back when. Like, it was before the full album came out. It was one of the singles. All right, hopping into Maybe Man here, the first song.
Wish I was a stone, so I couldn't feel.
And Alan already said that he thinks the lyrics are very cheesy, at least in the song.
But I'd miss the way we make up and smile. Don't wanna be stone.
Okay, I don't again, I'm gonna be try to understand, like, understanding, and I hope you try to like be understanding of each other's opinion here. I like the way it's set up. So like the whole song is kind of like, if I was this, then I would have these benefits, but then my life, like, it wouldn't be the way I want my life to be, so I don't want to be that.
Well, I think the reason why I think the lyrics are so bad is because I listen to hip-hop more, which is like...
Well, yeah, that's like completely lyric-based,
yeah,
too.
So maybe I've just like seen so many good lyricism that this just looks horrible.
Like, hip-hop genre, it's kind of like... That's where your, you know, that's where your comfort zone is. So when you hear something, you know, that's like, you're like, you know, you don't want to mess with it.
My mind, I wish I had eyes in the back of my head, then I could see the place.
Okay, I will say this line here, the where like it flops on his head, but I don't want to know what my friends think. Instead of keeping the rhyme scheme, I think it's kind of dumb.
Wanna know what my friends think. Wish I were my dog.
Okay, you gotta admit though, this backtrack, the violin coming in, is really good.
I miss her when she's gone. I wish I could act in a show.
Oh, by the way, there's gonna be a song later in the album that's dedicated to their dead dad. Oh, feel that guilt while you're reacting to it.
I wish that my brain.
Okay, I really like the part where it's like, ding 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 ding. Appreciate
the
instrumental.
Really where they shine, so if they stick to that, I feel like they could be better, but
dude, some people hate their instrumental.
Really?
Yeah, they like are like think it's so bad. And they like their old songs maybe, but like these new, like especially on this album, the instrumentals, mwah, chef's kiss.
They improved on that.
Yeah.
We're tripping in size, I nail every joke, I'd win every fight, but I get covered the bill, but couldn't complain about anything small. Nobody'd feel bad for me at all.
So I kind of like how throughout the song as well, because it's kind of like building up, right? Like the things he's saying. Like, and we're gonna try to look past the cheesy lyrics for a second here. You know, you go from like a stone, like a tiny little stone, and you're kind of increasing in size, and so it's building up. And as the lyrics build up, this melody, this instrumental is also building up slowly in the background, which is, I think it's a nice detail.
I get invited to every frat, but when you get old and you're good to haunt me when you're sad, wish I was a song.
This is the part where I think they need a different singer. because I don't think he can hit this very well. But I still like the song. Again, this is coming from a guy who listens to this on the regular. So, my criticisms of this aren't too valid. If I was
big as my house. This is a house, really, as big as my house. Are you serious?
Okay, I will say, we should have watched the music video for this, because the music video is really cool, like, just visually. Like, it's like this painty style.
As big as my house. Oh my gosh, that's actually just makes me shrink back, cringe.
Anyway, let's get back to it. Free crowd, but I wouldn't fit on my therapist's couch. God, I could really use him now. I wish I was God. I never trip up. And if I did, well, so fucking what? I could be cruel and break all your stuff. Get kind of weird, cause it would only say what I wanna hear. And then you would die. You'd love me to death. I never know who. The lyrics were better?
Yeah. Even though he's not a good singer, I feel like he did
a good job at that part, yeah. I think, like, the lyrics for that part aren't too bad. I feel like that's... And I give a shit. Hey, I'll be whatever makes you a fan. Cause I don't know who the hell I am. I don't like the 1-2 hit. But the instrument. Again, and then I'll pause here in a second. Okay, so you can hear in that part, it like cuts into like really random, like different instruments. And I listened to an interview, they were going for the feeling there of like switching between like channels on a TV.
That's what they were trying to do?
So like that kind of not like in the lyrics and stuff, but just like going from like one thing to another really quickly to kind of give like a mix of different things. I think it actually works really well in this song. Okay, that's the first song.
Alright,
any closing thoughts you'd like to give?
I think that's a decent 4, honestly.
Decent 4 out of 10. Oh yeah, we'll do like we'll rank the songs out of 10 each time. I think that song, in my personal opinion, is like an 8 out of 10. Would be higher if the lyrics were a little better.
Look, it would be like an average 5 if they didn't have that annoying part at the end. I swear.
I didn't like the 1-2 pan. I like the instrumental on that part. I don't like the 1-2 pandemonium. I think it's a little silly. Album is Touchy Feely Fool. I don't know. I think I might like this song actually more than Maybe Man.
Which song do you think I'm gonna be okay with?
The dumb song. I think you'll think it's like, cause it's more like, you know.
Well, earlier when you said that, I thought you meant like literally it was dumb, but.
No, it's literally called the dumb song. So. This one's kind of weird because whenever I first heard it, I interpreted it as like kind of relating to someone breaking up with someone and then having a hard time getting over them. But I think the lyrics are actually about something else, but that's just how I interpreted it. So that's what I like to go in with. I
think they could have chose better on the title. Honestly.
Yeah. But I knock on wood a lot, praying I'll wake up tomorrow, get the guts to tell you off, but I'll crawl back to you tomorrow. Why the hell can't I get mad? Okay, I think I have some bias toward this song too, because I had a relationship that was like my past relationship that was like very similar to this, and so I feel like I have
like
mm-hmm. Have you ever been in a relationship at all?
No.
So, Alan's not going to get this one as much, I feel like.
Okay, but hey, now you're going to know the outside
True.
Perspective.
True, the outside perspective, the other side of the coin here.
It's okay so far, it doesn't make me mad yet.
Okay. Okay, I think here, this is like, the part that really connected to me was he's kind of like saying, oh, someday this is going to be something I laugh at. Yeah. But right now it sucks. Right now, and so I got to kind of go through the suck to get to that.
Yeah. Honestly, I feel like the lyrics are actually a little better on
the song. On the song, yeah. I agree.
Or maybe I'm just used to the cheesiness. Who knows?
True. I think it does get a little cheesy in the chorus. Hey, what can you do? I would give anything to not give a beep about you. Okay, you might not get it, but it's like when you like break off a connection with somebody that you really, really cared about, it's hard to stop, just immediately stop like feeling care for them. So like it's someone that like screwed you over, but you cared for them so much, so you still have this lingering care, but you really don't want to care about them, you know what I mean?
You know, this song, I do think, is better than the last one so far.
It's good. I think you'll like the first half of the album much more than the second half, too, by the way. Life is pretty cruel. The next video might be cool. I would give anything to not give a shit, but I do. Dion. I would give anything to not give a shit. Well, I'm not too claustrophobic, but I lose my breath sometimes. Okay, so now here's where we get to the point where it's kind of kind of loses the whole, like, oh, it's about a relationship. Because it talks about, like, lawyers. So I think what happened... I think what happened was he was working with a partner for the whole brand of AJR, and they started, like, stealing money and stuff from them behind their back. And so this is kind of about them having a personal connection with that person that was a part of their company, and then them screwing them over. And so, like, it's kind of the same thing, but just in, like, a platonic sense of, you know, more business-wise.
AJR makes money.
Dude, these freaking songs, 2.1 million views. Dude, AJR is, like, popular. Like, they have a big fan base. Anyway. Talk to ya, now your lawyers talk to mine. Could you teach me to be rude? Better off like you. I'm better off a stick. I don't like better off a stone. I'm better off a jerk. I'm better off alone. I'm better. Like the clapping in the background, the ch ch ch
ch ch ch ch. Their instrumentals are pretty consistent.
Yeah.
I would give anything to that. Kyle, even though it's better than the last song, it is kind of uninteresting, I'm going to be honest.
You're, like, getting bored? Yeah. I feel like that is with some of the songs. That's how it is. But it's about to be done. I do think some of the songs have that problem, where if you're not a fan, you're not going to get into it, because it's kind of, like, loses your interest. So that was Touchy Feely Fool. I give that song a solid 9 out of 10 just because I have such a personal connect. I just have such a personal connection with it. And then I also am like a fan of the lyrics and the instrumental.
Honestly, I'll give that like a high five.
Like five and a half, maybe?
Yeah, sure. 5.5.
Okay. I think...
average.
Okay. Perfectly average. Like you'd... like if I had this on... driving somewhere, you
wouldn't stop you.
Yeah, okay. Gotcha. Yeah, I think that's fair. I like the like western vibe of it though. So this song's about like the dream of like, oh, you know, if like you screwed up with your friends and the people you care about so much that it's like the dream of just kind of pushing it all away and starting, you know, a new life somewhere else. So that's kind of like the theme of this song. Yeah, I've watched like multiple interviews about it. I've watched fun fact videos about it. Dude, I'm a big fan of AJR.
In the title, when you said super fan, you really didn't.
No, yeah, no, they're from my favorite band. What we should do though, because I think it'll only be fair, is if we sometime do a reaction to an album of one of the artists you like, because I don't like the same music you like at all.
I swear, if you listen to one of my artists, it's you're gonna be blown out of the water.
We're gonna listen. What Tyler the Creator?
No, I don't think. That might be a good place
or Kendrick.
To start. I'm not sure.
See, I think it'd only be fair, though, since I'm, like, forcing you to sit through this.
You know, it's cool, though, because I'm still learning a lot about AJR.
Yes. And you're also, like, just learning about the music world in general, because we're both trying to, like, get into music, kind of. So, I've dipped my toes in the music water a little bit.
Here for life, yeah, I'm in it now, I'm in it now. Could I start again somehow? Yes, I'm a mess with it again, cheers to the 2010s. I can hit my guts when the sun comes up, but I like my skin.
I like this one. I think this might be the one I showed you.
Why should I fix the shit stink? And I'll tell my boss what I really think. Yeah, I'm in it now, I'm in it now. Could I start again somehow?
I think that's how you are with quite a few AJR songs. You don't like most of them you don't like, but some of them you just don't care for. Like, you could listen or you could not, and it doesn't really bother you either way. Yeah.
Just got stressed filling up my head. So I spent last night blowing up my life and cheers to the 2010s.
I'm trying to, like, be nice too, because, like, or, like, not be too, like, you should like it too much. Because, like, I know if we do a song where I react to your album, you're going to be like, what do you mean this is heat?
No, Kyle, I swear. I'll tone it back when the time comes.
I don't like how their bridges are usually just the chorus slightly different. I feel like you could do something so much more interesting with a bridge. Do you know what, like, the bridge of a song is?
I kind of have an understanding. It's kind of like to go from one place to another without kind of switching too drastically, right?
So it's like, it's kind of supposed to be a switch up in the song to recapture people's attention. So, like, that's why bridges are usually in the later parts of the song. It's supposed to, like, oh, what the song's different now. Let me pay attention to it. So that's what the point of a bridge is. So the bridge of No Hesitation would be the part where stop, drop, and roll to make them all heart tick. That's the bridge of No Hesitation.
Have I listened to that?
No Hesitation? I want you so bad. No hesitation. Yeah. Dude, okay. We might have to throw that in here because have you seen the music video for it?
Oh, you made a music video?
I made, like, a silly music video for it. No. We'll have to react to it at the end. I'll throw it in with the AJR songs. You can compare my songs to the AJR songs. I think my songs have a stupid amount of influence of AJR, though.
Even though your songs do have an influence of them, I do think that this might be biased, but I do think your singing it might be better than this guy. Like, I'm not even joking.
I think, I think he sounds like if, like, a not-so-great singer, like, went to singing lessons for a really long time.
Yeah.
And, like, made their voice the best as possible, but it still isn't quite there.
Yeah.
I don't know. I like his singing, but it really depends on the song for me. You don't seem to hate these lyrics as much as the sun comes up,
but I guess that's what this is. I like myself like this.
I'm gonna give it. Actually, I'll let. I don't want to influence your rating, so I'll let you go first.
I don't think that was better than the last song, but it wasn't worse than the first, so I'll just give it like a low five.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna give it. Honestly, this is like one of my less liked ones in the album, so I'm gonna go a 7.
Critically acclaimed.
Okay. So this is the dumb song. Okay, and I'm not saying you're gonna like this because your taste is obviously different from YouTube critics, but this is the song that most people on YouTube that I saw reacted to this album, they were like, the dumb song is tolerable, the rest are trash. So, right,
yeah.
We'll see.
Let's see
if your thoughts align there.
By YouTube critics, do you mean people like Anthony Fantano?
Yeah.
Dude, I think
Anthony Fantano, and then, have you heard of Brad Taste in Music?
Ooh, I think I've heard that guy. Yeah,
he's like a big AJR hater, but, yeah. But I like watching that stuff because it's like opposing views, and I like learning about music. So
I see. When I'm whenever I watch someone like Anthony, kind of annoys me, honestly.
Dude, okay, I hate people they don't give that don't give like criticism. They just crap on it. They're like, "Yep, this was garbage." They move on. Because that's not enjoyable content. That's,
yeah, they only listen to like 5 seconds of it.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like
at least give it a shot. I don't think lyrics are too good in this one, but I think the instrumental makes it work.
You said with certainty, I may be the dumbest person that you've ever.
So I think the point of this song is supposed to kind of be like, you know, like people are saying, oh, you're too stupid to understand or stuff like that. So you're kind of like, oh, okay, well, if I'm too stupid to understand, then I'll just let you do all the work then.
You've mentioned Adderall.
Also, I think this is kind of about ADHD a little bit. I think it's slightly, that's like part of it. See, like this one, like you have your like head bobbing because it's like it keeps you, you know, interested. True.
Too dumb for breaking up. I do it in person, but I probably mess it.
Okay, I'm not gonna lie, that line hits me so hard because I've totally done that where like I'm too scared to break up with someone in person, so I do it over text.
Honestly, I feel like that line would hit harder if you didn't rhyme up with up.
That was silly.
You couldn't have found out another word.
That was silly.
I'll text you, that's enough. That's how empty-headed.
He literally just called me out of that line.
Don't look at me, don't look at me, I'm just too dumb. I'd love to stay, but like you said, don't look at.
A lot of people don't like the weird quirky sounds they'll add, but I think the weird like trumpets and stuff they're adding in this part, that like the weird, like, here if we can go back, you can kind of hear like really weird random little trumpet, but like I think that works for it. I think it fits in it.
I, you know, I could go with or without it.
Okay, I've ruined it for myself because I just think of someone like armpit farting into the microphone. Okay, no, listen carefully. No, listen carefully. I like that. I like the background.
Don't look at me, don't look at me, I'm just too dumb.
Okay, that song, let's hear your rating.
Honestly, that I actually kind of like that. Like, when I don't think about the lyrics, it's not too bad. I really like all the chords they got in here, too. It's really nice. Before you told me the
armpit fart.
Yeah, I had it on an 8, but
that's okay. That's not what they actually used, by the way. They used the actual trumpets. That's just what my brain thought of. So before that, it was an 8.
But now it's like I'd say it's a high 7.
Okay.
So I consider this good. I might come back to this on my own time.
Okay, I'm happy. I'm happy with that. There was an acoustic version, but I think the acoustic version you'd hate so much. I don't like it at all. This is number 5. almost.
Oh,
Well, you know what I should have done? I should have had you like say your complete thoughts on AJR and then listen to the album and then do another one of complete thoughts.
Don't worry about it. We can add that later in the video.
No, I'm not. I don't want to clickbait, bro.
No one has to know, Kyle.
You just like say the same thing twice. But she met your family and dating's the worst, yeah. Now you're not in love anymore. But you'll... It's like saying you fell out of love in a relationship, or like you fell out of a connection, but you don't want to leave that connection because, like. No, it's like, okay, so the song's about like being.
Not wanting to change.
Yeah, not wanting to change. So, like, I think this is kind of showing, like, oh, I don't want to break up with someone though, because it's difficult to go through all that, so I'm just going to stick it out for, you know, however long. I guess this is just what I am. I think this chorus is so long. Yeah. Oh, it's just almost a 4-minute song in the last one. Don't worry, Alan. I wanna move, but I'm fucking hungry and screw you, I'm trying. Yeah, that's a really cheesy line. I wanna be big like my plans, so why am I so tiny and why am I so mad? It's inertia, guess this is... Alright, and then it's just the chorus again, so... Right, yeah, we're gonna skip over that. Okay. You go ahead.
Honestly... Probably
also, turn your chair this way, so you're, like, in the video. What are you saying?
Probably, like, a low five.
Low five?
This album is just mediocrity over and over again. It's just...
Anyway, I think you'd hate OK Orchestra. I don't think you'd like any of the songs on there. What is it?
Remember, it was, like, World's Smallest
Violin.
That song just annoys me now. I think I used to like it, but I heard it so
much. Yeah, I feel like internet ruined that song. One we'll listen to. This is Turning Out Part 3. This one needs a little bit of background. So there was a Turning Out Part 1 they made, Turning Out Part 2 they made. So basically each of them are kind of about one of the members' like love life, and they wanted to write love songs that weren't traditional love songs where it's just very praisey and kind of skips over a lot of the problems of relationships, and you know, like all the songs about relationships and pop are very unrealistic. So he's trying to make a realistic love song, if that makes sense. So that's, you know, just a little bit of context there. I think you'll think it's a little cringy at parts. But I love this whole song. It's like, I think my favorite song on the album. Well, I wanted to be wanted. Suddenly I'm wanting more. I also have bias toward the song because I relate to it a lot. I think this guy's a better singer. This isn't the same guy. It's a different guy singing. So, what I like about this, and like why I think it's so good, is he's kind of afraid of losing the spark of the relationship. So he's saying, let's move on really quickly. Let's go through life. Let's get kids. Let's get a house. Let's get married, you know, so we can kind of get to a point where it's permanent. But when you do that, it kind of skews the relationship and can ruin it. By the way, for context, their parents got divorced. Yeah, like all three of them. They're all brothers. And I think they had a dog. But you're late and you're messy, aren't you? And I need too much attention. Do you think he's gonna watch the end of this video? Life is pretty. If you're still here, like, could turn into everyone's got it. Don't overthink it. One day at a time, kid. I think you'll think this part's kind of cringy. Got someone to do life with. Don't overthink it. It's not fucking science. Add up the days, you got someone to do life with. Up the days. Also, I don't think you'll relate to it at all, because you just haven't gone through anything. Big kid, it's little and quiet. Let's do today. I think you'll turn out to like it. Okay, the reason why I like the ending so much on that one, is because I relate to having, like, when you're, like, our age, right, and you're going into a relationship, you expect, like, you know, love on TV shows and movies. It's all this big thing, this big moment where you lock eyes for the first time and, whoa. But in this song, it's kind of saying real love is making a connection with somebody, and it's not this big thing where it's going to be love at first sight and, you know, all these super romantic feelings. It's just going to be building a connection with each other over time, day by day. And that's kind of the message, and I really like the message of the song. I like how it ends. So, anyway, yeah, that's it. Well, you got to give this one a rating.
Oh, yeah. Honestly, I'm just going to hand out another 5.
Okay. I think you're going to hate me for this. I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10.
A 10 out of 10.
Really? I think that song is awesome. I love that song. Okay. But anyway. So, Alan, going out of this here.
First half of the album.
This is the first half of the album. What are your thoughts as a whole on all the songs that you've listened to today?
Well, even though this might have been an improvement from their other albums, it's just boring, boring, boring. And then some, like, cool instrumental sprinkled in. But honestly, if we listened to the full album, I probably would have fell asleep, Kyle.
It was very boring to you?
Yeah, but I guess I don't really hate it, except for that one song, but I don't know, I feel like they could have done more.
So, your least favorite so far is the first one of the album, right?
Definitely. Okay. Do you think that's going to change when I listen to the other half?
I think you're going to hate Steve's Going to London. Anyway. That's for next video here. I hope you guys look at the camera. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see part 2 where Alan rips his eyeballs out, listening to AJR once again, or if you want to see me react to Alan's whatever he wants me to react to. What album?
The very first album I ever listened to is this this album called Igor Kyle.
Is that Tyler the Creator? Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna listen to Tyler the Creator album in the next video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, ready for more KP and Alan content. Yeah. We're finally both back from our long trips. We had like a big old break in between the last video. But well, I guess except for my music video. Yep, we're gonna be doing a lot. We have a lot more. We have a green screen now. We have a camera now. So we're going to be doing a lot cooler things. We're probably going to revisit something similar to versus the multiverse eventually. So that'll be fun. But yeah. Hope you guys like this video. See you guys in the next one. Peace.